What's up, everyone? Sam here from bitebybite.com, and in this video, I'm going to share with you the 3 steps to take to land a job in tech, even if you don't have a degree in computer science. All right, so this is the question that I get asked a ton, and I want to dig into this question of how do you get a job in tech when you don't have a degree in computer science? Because there are so many more people these days who are looking for those jobs. Maybe you went to a boot camp. Maybe you studied on your own. Maybe you just studied an adjacent skill and you want to transition into computer science because it's such a lucrative industry. Whatever it is, there are a lot of things that make it hard to get in because it is a competitive industry, but you can absolutely break into tech even if you don't have that CS degree and you don't need to go back to school to get one. So I want to talk today about the 3 things that you need to focus on, because there really are sort of 3 fundamental struggles that I see people have when they're trying to land a job in tech without that computer science degree, without that background. And the basic struggles are landing that initial interview, demonstrating that you have credibility, and then 3rd, passing the technical interview. So let's get into it. I want to share with you a couple strategies that you can use for each of these so that you're able to get through this process, you're able to land that job, and you're able to start that career in tech. And so first, how do you land the interview? Because at the end of the day, it's really hard to land an interview without already having experience, right? Like, we've all seen these things where it's like an entry-level job and they want 5 years of experience, right? And so how do we actually break through that? And how do we actually get ourselves out there? And so there are 2 specific strategies that I want you to think about. So 1, which people really don't do but is really valuable, is optimizing your LinkedIn profile. Because let's be honest, at the end of the day, LinkedIn is where recruiters are looking for people to hire, right? If we put ourselves in the recruiter's shoes and we thought, you know, I need to hire someone to work as a software developer at my company, where am I going to look? The obvious answer is LinkedIn, right? Because everyone's there. You can find out all of their work history. You can find out all that information. And so optimizing your LinkedIn is really, really valuable. So how do you do this? It's pretty simple. There's not a lot to it, but it's all about putting keywords and putting things that you think that your recruiter is going to be looking for. So make sure that if you have any experience, if you have any side projects, if you have any, you know, relevant education, make sure that you're putting all of that on your LinkedIn profile. And you can also update like the description, you can update all these different pieces so that when a recruiter is looking for software developer or software engineer or, you know, remote developer, whatever it is that you're looking for, you want your profile to be showing up. And so you can connect with lots of people, you can optimize for those keywords, and that's going to make a huge difference. And you can also say on LinkedIn, I am openly looking for jobs, right? So just these little things and making sure that your LinkedIn is accurate and everything is filled out is going to make a huge difference because it's going to allow recruiters to find you. Secondly, you can use an outbound approach. And so we all know, we've all heard that the way to get a job is from referrals, right? Like, you don't want to just do a resume drop, you actually want to get a referral. And so if you already have people you know who work at different companies, that's great because you basically have a built-in referral network, right? Like, you're not going to have to go out and find people to refer you at a given company. However, if you don't know people, that doesn't mean that you can't get a referral. There's actually a process that you can take to land referrals, and the basic process is that you are going to do informational interviews. So you're going to reach out to someone and you're going to be like, hey, I just want to learn a little bit about the company. You're not going to ask them for anything. You're just going to ask them to share their experience. You're not going to ask them for a referral. And then all you're going to do is after that, you can follow up with them if you have a good conversation. And you can basically say, you know, is there anyone else that I can talk to that you think would be a good fit for me to talk to at the company? And by doing this, you're going to be able to go to that second person and show that you understand the company, show that you're a really good fit, and that's going to allow you to then ask for the referral. So now that we've actually landed the interview, the next thing that we have to do is we have to demonstrate that credibility. And this is also going to help us with landing the interview, but your credibility is so much more important when you are coming without a degree and coming without previous engineering experience. And so how do we show them that we are a credible person? How do we show them that, you know, we know what we're talking about? And this is where it really comes down to side projects and open source projects, right? At the end of the day, those are the things that are going to show them that you're serious. Those are the things that are going to show them that, you know, you have that credibility. And so by working on side projects and working on open source projects, you're gonna build that experience and you're gonna be able to demonstrate credibility by putting those on your resume. So in terms of side projects, I do wanna talk about this briefly. I think so many people, when they look at, when they're thinking about creating a side project, they're like, they have these grand visions of, oh, I need to get 10,000 users, or oh, I need to come up with some creative idea. And the fact of the matter is that you don't need to do any of that. And honestly, you're probably not gonna do that. Because with a side project, here's the thing that people don't realize. There's the technical side and there is the business side. So getting 10,000 users on your app has nothing to do with your technical ability. The only thing that it has to do with is your business ability. And so if you really want to build an app that has 10,000 users, you're going to have to spend your time split between building the app and then actually recruiting people to use the app. And also you're going to have to come up with a good idea on top of all of that, and you're going to have to support everybody. So when you're thinking about building side projects, it's much more about learning and having something that's demonstrable than creating something amazing. So the best way that you can do this and the best way that you can learn the fastest is to basically clone existing apps that are out there, right? You could make a clone of Instagram, you could make a clone of Reddit, you could make a clone of Wikipedia. And the key thing is that now you don't have to do any design work because the design work has already been done. You don't have to do a lot of the like sort of nitty gritty stuff because you're not creating this to like publish to the world. We don't have to worry about like copyright or anything like that. Let's just copy all the like assets and use it to practice building something. And you can say, hey, I want to practice this technology. I want to practice React, or I want to practice, you know, using Node.js or whatever it is. And you can practice that with the side project. And you already have basically the project management and the like design of the app done for you. You're just implementing. So that's what I want you to think about with side projects. And now the third thing that we need to have prepared when we want to land that job in tech is we need to be able to pass the technical interview. So this is super, super important because at the end of the day, that's how these companies are evaluating people. Like, you want to have that extra credibility because it gives you a boost. You're going to need to get that interview in the first place. But at the end of the day, once you get the interview, it's about passing the interview and it's about getting through the gauntlet, right? And so to do that, you're going to need to pass your technical interview. And the way that I like to teach this is with the three pillars of interviewing. So here we basically have the three core areas that you need to focus on. And I've gone into this in other videos, so I'm not gonna go into it in depth here. But basically the three things you need to do are, one, focus deeply on understanding the fundamentals, especially if you don't have a degree. You really need to make sure that you understand your fundamental data structures and algorithms. Then secondly, you wanna have a strategy, right? You wanna be able to apply this stuff and be able to get it out of your head when you're in the interview. Because if you don't have a strategy and you don't know how you're gonna approach these problems, it's gonna be really difficult. And then third, you wanna have that confidence. And this is something that you can learn. I highly recommend doing practice interviews, doing mock interviews as a way to build your confidence. If you go to bitebybite.com/pramp, you can get unlimited credits on Pramp to do free peer-to-peer mock interviews. And this is a great way to build that self-confidence, which is so, so important in the interview. Because if you don't have confidence, it makes you perform worse, which makes your confidence worse, which makes you perform even worse, and you get in this like negative spiral where it's impossible to succeed if you don't have the confidence. And so that's the three pillars of interviewing in a nutshell. And by focusing on these three areas, you're gonna have what you need to be able to pass that technical interview. And so just to recap briefly, you know, there are three main things that you need to focus on when you are trying to get a job in tech without a CS degree. And those are landing the interview in the first place, which I highly recommend reaching out for referrals and optimizing your LinkedIn profile. It's demonstrating that credibility by doing the side projects, by doing open source, maybe by doing hackathons, doing all these sorts of things. And then third, passing the technical interview, practicing that using the three pillars of interviewing and doing mock interviews. And then finally, I just want to add one more point that I think is super important that people don't want to talk about because it's not sexy. This is not the thing that you're gonna wanna hear, but at the end of the day, if you're trying to get that first job in tech and you don't have a computer science background, it's going to be challenging and you might have to take a job that is not your first choice, right? You may not be able to get into that interview at a company, at a top tier company, if you haven't done work as a software engineer before. That may just be the way of the world. And even if you are able to get in, it's gonna be hard for you to pass that interview. So you might need to take a job at a company that's like not in an optimal location. It's not like your dream company. It's not, you know, your dream city. But what you're doing is you're building up your credibility. Again, you're building that skill, and then it may take you a couple years. You may spend a year at one company and then you may go to another company for a year. But once you build up that expertise, now you can start moving into those higher and higher companies. And I call this laddering up, right? Because that's basically what you're doing, is you're walking up the rungs of the ladder. And eventually you will get to where you need to go and you will get to that job that you're dreaming about, but realize that you don't have to do this all at once. And if you just follow the steps and you keep working at it, you will get there. It just is a process and it just takes time. And so on that note, thank you for sticking around to the end of this video. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe and give us a like. And we also have our free 50 interview questions guide for you to download. So definitely go check that out as well. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.